Get all your stuff?
Yeah.
What do you got there? Is that where you stash all your stuff?
I don't know.
Huh?
Stuff, man. What was it? It was supposed to be laundry.
Laundry?
Yeah, look.
In that dark hole, that's where you put all your stuff?
Well, yeah.
Let's see. Hold it. Let me see. We got a toothbrush, a pen. What's this?
Something I found on the motorcycle ride in the street. It's a paintbrush of sorts.
What are you going to do with it?
I do artwork.
Really?
Yeah, on my little thing in my home, in my tree fort.
In the tree fort?
Yeah, I use this to like make little paintings in the tree fort.
Really?
Yeah.
What happened to that skunk or that cat that you used to hang out with in the tree fort?
I saw the biggest skunk I ever saw in my whole life crawl right in front of me one night.
Really?
Like at 2 or 3 in the morning.
Really?
A really big one, like as big as a dog or something.
No way.
And I was scared.
What'd you do?
I covered up with my blanket like this because...
You didn't start crying, did you?
No, I was scared though. You don't want to make him mad at you because he really smelled bad.
Ew.
And worse than that, you probably throw up.
Oh, God.
Because I've seen dogs that got it really bad and it came home to me.
Yeah.
And I started throwing up.
Okay.
Okay, so...
All right.
Because I lived in the country a long time.
I know.
And I...
Well, speaking about living in the country, what about living in that cave for 8 years in Maui in Hawaii? How was that?
Oh, great. That was one of the best times of my life.
Wow.
But I also got to go to work in these nice restaurants, and I was the dishwasher.
I see.
And we had tiki torches at night and everything. Every night it was like as much fun as going to any party.
Okay.
And surf the best waves in the world.
Honolulu Bay, huh?
Honolulu Bay, yeah.
Best right in the world.
One of them.
One of them, yeah.
For real.
Explain what's all in the little package here.
This was laundry.
Okay.
And it got mixed up with my cell phone and my charger and...
I'm glad you got one.
I know, me too.
Remember how hard it was before cell phones to get hold of you, Sticky?
Oh gosh, even nowadays.
Really?
Yeah. So now what I'm trying to do is just like make sure that my boss, Eric, is happy with me.
I am.
And my performance.
We are.
Okay. And I know you guys had a baby shower, really good thing, man.
Yeah.
Well, I'm trying to get everything together for laundry so I can go see Peter Kenton play his guitar.
Okay. Why not?
Yeah.
Where's all the army men and the toys and the briefcase?
They're at my tree fort.
The army men are in the tree fort?
Everything, yeah. Cowboys and Indians and army men and all that good stuff.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Wow.
I've always had a tree fort. You know, it doesn't cost me nothing on state property.
I remember when I was a transient, when you taught me how to be one, when I was putting all my money in the antique business. You remember that?
Yeah.
And when you worked, we did all the antique shows around the country.
Yeah, when we traveled across country.
Yeah. And that one time I had to sleep in the tree fort, and I was walking down the hill in La Jolla in the morning. I was so embarrassed. People were looking at me coming out.
Oh, dirtied out.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Coming
out of the bushes. Remember that?
Yeah, I've been there.
Okay.
Well, you know, it's really hard. That's too bad, Eric.
Man. I know, but you taught me how to shower in a jacuzzi, right?
Well, I don't shower in a jacuzzi. I go in jacuzzis. I don't go in there with soap or nothing.
I did, huh?
Yeah.
Remember I got caught in La Jolla?
Yeah. With soap shaving in the jacuzzi. Yeah. And then next thing you know, they closed the place with a big door so no one could go in.
Oh, yeah. I know.
Look, here's what I really look like, you guys. I mean, this is what I really look like.
Okay.
And nobody wants to hire somebody like me to do the yard work except for you, Eric, huh?
That's about it, because I don't really
think,
care.
First they think like, oh my God, that guy's the worst guy I've ever seen. But after it's all said and done, and you know me, I do the best job of anybody out there.
Right.
But it takes a while for people to see these things. You know, I forgive them.
Yeah. I mean, nobody would, you know, they're all like, oh, La Jolla, or try to, you know, phony baloney. And
yeah, so, oh, La Jolla's hard, nah. Man. You think living in La Jolla is a good thing? Easy? Yeah. Well, let me tell you something. You've got to work at it, man. La Jolla's tough.
Yeah.
I work in downtown La Jolla at the La Valencia Hotel, and I'm telling you, people don't believe it. No, you don't. Okay.
Well, the detail in the cars and the lot.
Yeah, Mercedes-Benz, nice BMWs.
Yeah.
Jaguar cars.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, good. Good deal. Right on, Stecky.
Thanks for the chance to be your friend, and you know, on the film too, man. It's kind of funny. I don't know what you're gonna do with this, Eric, but
well, I'm gonna let these, you know, producers see if they want to deal with us. You know, it's up to them. It's not us.
It's hard to have someone point a camera at you all the time. It's kind of like something I'm not really used to.
Me neither, but I think we can get used to it. You know, and better cameras, better resolution, better lenses, and I think a lot of people would like to know what the California surfers are.
How do they get the day off to go surfing when the waves are good anytime they want? I wonder how they do that.
We just go. It's, we just go. You and I would just go.
They
can go to the beach with us.
Over this one.
Wow, what's that one, Sec?
This is just another one. You get cold on motorbikes.
I bet.
My motorbike's not running good. It needs help. I got to tighten down the carburetor.
Make sure you look both ways because people are on cell phones now. The drunks are the passe. That's over with. That was the 80s and the 70s. It's not the drunks anymore. It's the cell phoners.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so do you really double check so we don't want, you know, nothing happening.
I'm not going to fall now. Thanks, Eric.
No, seriously.
I'm not going to fall off this little thing here.
It's them. It's the girls with the smiles. When you see them with smiles, that means they're really deep in their conversation. That when they have the smiles and the glow.
And they're driving on the phone.
Yeah, yeah, and that gleam. Yeah. They're usually talking to their boyfriend is what my mind told me.
Uh-huh.
They're having
a heated discussion behind the wheel.
Yeah, so you really think that they're paying attention to their mind.
I gotcha.
They're floating.
Oh, in their minds, and they're not, they don't see you really. Right?
Way worse than a drunk, unless it's a really drunk.
Okay.
So, watch out for these people.
This driving thing is serious to me, you guys. I mean, it's number one cause of death in America is traffic.
Yeah.
Our buddy just ran through the restaurant and hurt people the other night.
No, that's a failure, yeah, he did a lot.
Can't believe it.
Wait, let's see the beach towel. What do you got to turn around? You got the beach towel?
Laundry.
Yeah.
I'm doing my laundry. I got to do it because it's got to be done.
Okay.
And.
All right. And then we're going
to. I have to start the motorcycle down the street like I do.
Yeah.
I just go put my stuff. I got to do my laundry. It's really important.
Okay.
Okay.
And then when are we going to finish up this landscape out front?
It's getting late.
Okay.
In the evenings, I like to combine with landscaping.
Yeah, and tomorrow's Sunday.
Sunday, we're not going to do nothing tomorrow.
A little bit, maybe?
Maybe an hour, yeah.
Maybe a couple hours. Maybe we just wipe it out and just keep going?
Well, tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
You know.
Just a little couple hours tomorrow.
Yeah.
Okay, you got a deal.
Yeah, right on.
Do I look like Superman with my cape and stuff?
Whoa.
You know, this is all this real stuff. We're not planning any of this, you see here, anybody. I mean, look at that. Think they're going to pull me over or what?
I would.
I bet.
But the cops all know you, so they don't.
They like me. They'll be waving. They'll just be going, "Jeez."
Oh my goodness.
Let's see.
Well, I gotta stand up and get a view. I'm kind of tight shot here. I gotta get farther back.
Don't be afraid of this. I am a very, very experienced motorbike rider.
Right.
I've had about 50 motorbikes in my lifetime.
How many guns do you have, Scott?
Right now, I have access to about 53 guns.
No, but really,
I collect them. I specialize in pistols.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Remember, everybody.
But I mean well with everything about it. These are collector items that, you know, $15, $2,000, just the equipment itself.
No, that's theirs. But how many do you own? You said you own 7.
I actually do not own a firearm right now. But I have BB guns, but no firearms under my name because that's just how it is. It's kind of rare. I've spent since I was a 10-year-old child, I've always had a gun. A real one.
Remember, everybody run.
I have one now.
Stecker's got another gun.
Let's see if I can start the motorbike.
Don't start it, you know, down the.
It only starts in third gear.
Okay, don't forget, tomorrow we're doing we got to finish this up. It's, you know, we got to whack this out. It's in the fall here. I want to get this done.
It's in third gear.
I want to photograph why we saw the summer light. The fall gets really kind of dark light. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, the place is looking greater.
Well, we got
to get to that mess. It's hard. Progress.
Yeah, it's okay. Let's finish it. Jesus. Oh, man.